Good afternoon, 47. Your target is already inside the Miami Bayside Center. Faber has a full day of meetings planned, and we do not want to risk losing him. Take your time with this one. Dave Reddy, our informant, is waiting for you in the reception area. If you like, he can lead you to a meeting where Faber will be in attendance. What you do from then on is up to you. Be mindful, though. He will not wait around for long.
You must be Dave Reddy.
Ah, yes. You're the one I've been expecting. The special guest.
I am.
Okay. So like I told your superiors, I can get you inside the meeting, but that's it. What you do from there is up to you. Got it?
Just how I like it.
All right. But, you can't go in dressed like that. You'll need to look like an engineer or one of the lab guys or a guard, I guess.
I'll work something out.
Good.
The ICA has struck a deal with Dave Reddy, one of the two men your target has come to Miami to meet with. Reddy got in some trouble with the Moreno cartel, and the ICA has promised to clear it up for him if he helps us get close to Mark Faber. Reddy is currently waiting for you in the reception area of the Bayside Center.
I'll wait for you here. Don't take too long. They're expecting us upstairs in the conference room.
How's this?
Where'd you find that? Never mind. I don't want to know. Let's go. Faber's already expecting us up there.
Can't wait to meet him.
This guy's with me.
Looking good today, sir.
So, this deal is closed when we enter the room, all right? I get you in, that's all. And then your people take care of my problem.
Don't worry. We'll fulfill our end of the bargain.
Solid. I don't know what I was thinking, honestly. Getting involved with people like the Morenos, it was stupid. I thought I could make some quick cash, you know? Buy that yacht, sail a couple of babes to the Caribbean for the summer. Stupid!
The Moreno cartel is the biggest in the Southern Hemisphere. You don't try to cheat those kind of people.
Wish I'd met you a little earlier, buddy.
Could have used that advice 6 months ago, you know? Anyway, we're almost there, so let's put on our game faces.
Hi.
I'm here.
So, we finally meet. You don't quite look like I expected. I'm Mark Faber.
Mr. Faber! What an absolute pleasure to meet you. I'm Dave Reddy, Special Acquisitions Gatekeeper, working with you on this job. I'd show you my break book, but I'm sure you've already heard about me.
Can't say that I have.
Oh, I see. Before we begin, I just wanted to tell you that I've read up on your file. Oh, man, very impressive.
It's all about enjoying what you do.
Couldn't agree more, my friend. I've prepped an extensive briefing to help us sync up on the subject that needs to be, consulted with. I think it'll provide you with a full 360.
Good. Let's proceed.
Hey, not a problem, Mark. Not a problem at all. All right, well, let's grab a seat and get this show on the road.
Okay, so the consultation is with a man called Pavel Sukhov, a relative of your boss's former partner.
10-4. For the last 6 months, Sukhov has been dishing out malicious rumors about my good friend Bob Knox. Did some digging, and it turns out he's publishing a book about the secret beginning of Kron's dead industry. It's completely ridiculous, and rumors are putting a hard stop on the door of our stuff. Things in the media lately.
So, Knox is looking to protect the bottom line. This Sukhov fella, he's enjoying the limelight. There was a press conference a week ago, yeah?
Huh. You've really done your homework. You're right. He's showering in media attention. Is that going to be a problem?
On the contrary. I prefer public consultations. Nowhere better to hide than in the middle of a spectacle.
Well, then this is your bluebird, my friend.
You know what? Let's try a small exercise. You. Suppose you were sent to kill me. We're in this meeting together. You're sitting there in the chair, waiting for your moment. How would you kill me? What's the plan?
You've been drinking quite a lot of coffee.
Yes.
Fast-acting poison. Emetic. About 5 seconds from ingestion to reaction. Follow you to the bathroom. Drown you. Terrible accident.
Gruesome. But I survived worse than that. What else?
Cause a small distraction. Lure you out onto the balcony and throw you over the railing to your death below.
You look strong enough. But there are bushes down there. They break the fall. Might walk away without a single broken bone. Final bid?
Knife on the table over there. Quick throw. Knife through the head. You'd be dead before you hit the floor.
That's more like it. But very risky. You'd have a hard time escaping the room. But I would love to see you try that. I'll just head over to check on what that you guy's working on. You carry on. Hi, it's me. I've got a new act lined up. You've reviewed the plans.
Very public, because the target is public.
You shoot the guy and blow him up or something.
Excuse me, personnel only. Thank you.
You must be Mark Faber. I wish I could say I knew all about you, but Dave's been uncharacteristically secretive. You work in weapons development too?
More on the practical application side. What is a new face on war?
Of course. Nice. I looked at the diagram.
I have been already admired.
to my specifications yet.
No admission, sir.
So that explains the untraditional nature of the work.
Hey, how you doing?
Disappointing. Well, done is done. I suppose I'll have to try to figure out how to use this. So, this is Robert Knox's new brainchild. Chilling.
Sorry, sir. I can't let you through here. Please move on.
The robotic system in the world. The AI is world-class, too. Yeah, Mr. Knox designed this to make us all jobless in 20 years.
Yeah, I saw his talk on artificial intelligence last year. I'm more of a flesh-and-blood kind of guy than he is, I think.
But we could all become indestructible.
I certainly hope not. We'd all be up to the job then. Exactly a discreet container. But I suppose if we add balloons to the event, spray paint is too much.
Multiple compounds from this, effectively shaping its use based on what we
add
to it.
Oh, sir.
Well.
Oh, what the shit!
It's me. I just sent you the location for the next gig. I need you to build me a pop-up bookstore there. Should be able to hold about 50 people at a time. There'll be pyrotechnics going off downstairs. So we need to make
you
sure.
You ever see that movie about that bodyguard? Can't remember the title.
There's also an elevator in the back.
Close protection.
I need to be able to control by remote. No. No, the main event takes place on the top floor. Morgan's assured me we can lure anyone we need up there quite easily. We'll detonate the entire floor using a new type of explosive I'm hoping to secure today. No, the agent should live. We need the witness. We'll detonate once he fires off the first shot. Lucky hit on a nearby gas canister. Far-fetched, sure. They fell for the exploding fire extinguisher a few years ago. Sure it'll work. Right. I need to finish with an intel brief here, then I'll fly out to meet you.
Yeah. Oh, that reminds me. Kronstadt security system is really good. I should get one.
keep security tight.
Good day.
Never mind. Let's get back to it.
All right. So we know Zukov's planning on revealing the dragonflies to the world in New York next week. I paid off a call girl these 3 weeks. Did she let it slip?
Keeping it safe.
Contract killers and not as scary as Faye, but you've got this.
How much dial it down? Even
20%.
The more security, the better.
Or 30. 50 top.
Never enough security.
Perhaps if we dilute the ink inside the pen. VX poison or something along those lines. Something that made the victim experience extreme pain or undergo violent seizures, perhaps. It would need to look good on camera. I had my doubts seeing this initially, but this could be just what I'm looking for.
The octane booster itself isn't really the main attraction here. It's the Nox compound that's the real magician. Marketing just figured we'd pre-launch its octane booster format first, but it's not really the intended purpose. However, it so effectively rivals ethanol.
Okay, so you must be the bodyguard. If you don't mind me saying, you are ripped.
Complicated, foolish even, but the pro. Trust me not to judge me.
Stabbing weapon. Stupid. How am I supposed to create a memorable moment if I can't even get something as simple as an exploding pen? Maybe if it's just a small explosion. A precursor. Something that would set off a bigger thing. Would require an inside man.
Oh, perhaps magnesium might do the trick. It would certainly draw the eyes. No, the light would be blinding with a piece that large, so maybe that's actually counter to what is required.
So, how would one fit a flamethrower on you? Maybe a small one. Jet of fire from the mouth? A few more iterations of design, and you and I might be best friends, Mr. Robot.
Makes you think, doesn't it?
Somehow added a solidifying agent to this. Retards to keep it from drying out.
How you been?
Perhaps if we dilute the ink inside the pen with VX poison or something along those lines. Something that made the victim experience extreme pain or undergo violent seizures, perhaps. Would need to look good on camera.
Maybe if we somehow create a hard-baked C4 pen. Yeah, it would need some reinforcements to hold up. And well, the explosion still wouldn't be as devastating as desired, but... as a first step, perhaps. Yeah, I'll drop some plans and pass them on.
Robots, huh?
Target wire.
Huh? Plus, I am a big fan.
Right.
I may only be flesh and blood.
Command, reporting a possible situation. At first glance, it could be an accident. Command, affirmative. Bagging and tagging.
You're an interesting concept, my friend. Nobody would be able to resist the chance to get up close and personal with you. Which makes you very useful. I had my doubts seeing this initially. But this could be just what I'm looking for.
Have you heard the one about the banker and the horny police dog?
Back to the briefing room for a while. I'll see you later.
what are you...
Eliminated. Hopefully, this will be the last time we have to deal with Mr. Faber. The money is being transferred now, 47. Time to find an exit.
Keep that gun holstered, son.